Only if you marry do you have an opportunity to be a husband or a wife. Only if you marry do you have an opportunity to be a father or mother, which are very important duties in Islam. Baby, you can call me a superman.
Hey yo, what's up everybody, welcome back to our channel. It's your boy Jesse Keegan and we are Funny and Jesse. So right about now we're going to do another reaction video. But before we get into the reaction guys, I want to thank you so much for subscribing to our channel. You're really amazing. And also want to thank the people out there who've been giving us reaction videos. You're also amazing, super amazing. So right about now we're going to do another reaction video. I'm going to do another reaction video, and this one right here was suggested by a lot of people. They suggested that we should go react to rights of wife in Islam. Rights of a wife in Islam. And this one right here was from Dr. Zaki Naik. So without any further ado guys, let's get it.
Now we discuss the rights of the wife in Islam. Most of the other religions besides Islam, they consider the woman as an instrument of the devil. But the Quran refers to the woman as a muhsana. Muhsana in Arabic means a fortress against the devil. Because a pious woman who's on the straight path, she prevents the husband from deviating and going on the wrong track and keeps him on the Sirat al-Mustaqim. Therefore, she's called as Muhsana, a fortress against the devil. The Quran in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 21, refers to marriage, to nikah, as a sacred covenant. It's a sacred covenant, a sacred contract between the husband and wife. The Quran says in Surah Rum, chapter number 30, verse number 21, that we have created for you mates from amongst yourselves so that you may live with them in tranquility, and he has put love and mercy between your hearts. The beloved Prophet Muhammad, he said, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 7, in the book of Nikah, chapter number 3, hadith number 5066, the beloved Prophet said, O young people, whoever has the means to get married should get married. The beloved Prophet also said, there is no monasticism in Islam. And the Prophet said, anyone who marries, he completes half his deen. Once during question answer time, there was a person who asked me, that does it mean that if I marry twice, will I complete my full deen? What did the Prophet mean when he said that marriage completes half your deen? Marriage prevents you from promiscuity, from fornication, from homosexuality. Only if you marry do you have an opportunity to be a husband or a wife. Only if you marry do you have an opportunity to be a father or mother, which are very important duties in Islam. So irrespective whether you marry once or twice, you only complete half your deen. In Islam, for a marriage to solemnize, taking the permission of both would be husband and wife, the man and the woman, is equally important. The Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 19, do not inherit the woman against their wishes. The hadith is mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 7, book of Nikah, chapter number 43, hadith number 5138. A lady by the name of Khanza bin Khadim al Ansariya, she approached the Prophet and said, that my father has married me to a person against my wishes. The Prophet nullified the marriage. There's another Sahih hadith which mentions Ahmad ibn Hanbal, hadith number 2469, where a lady approaches the Prophet and says, that my parents have forced me to marry a man against my wishes. And the Prophet said, she has the option of either continuing a marriage or nullifying the marriage. There's a similar hadith mentioned in Ibn Majah, hadith number 1875. It's the same hadith. A woman approaches the Prophet and tells her that my parents have forced me to marry against my wish. And the Prophet says, you can either continue the marriage or you can nullify the marriage. And the woman says, I continued the marriage, but I wanted the woman to know that the parents cannot force their daughters to marry someone who they don't like. The Quran says in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 228, that the women have rights similar to those against them on terms equitable, but the men have a degree of advantage. Based on this verse of the Quran, men and women are equal except in leadership. The Quran clearly says that the women have rights, though similar to them, on terms equitable, but the men have a degree of advantage. Now many of the Muslims, they misunderstand this ending phrase that the men have a degree of advantage and they think that men are superior. And they quote the verse of the Quran, "Ar-rijalu qawwamuna 'alan nisaa," that the men are superior to the women. So Allah has said, the men have degree of advantage, the men are superior. What they're quoting is the verse of the Quran which was recited by one of the Qari from Surah Nisa chapter number 4, verse number 34, which says, "Ar-rijalu qawwamuna 'alan nisaa," that the men are the qawwam of the women. What is the meaning of the Arabic word qawwam? Qawwam comes from the root word akama, which means to stand up for. How we have akama before salah, we stand up for salah. So this Arabic word qawwam means the men have one degree of additional responsibility and one degree additional service towards the women, not one degree of superiority to boss over the women. And if you read the tafsir of Tabari, he says the Arabic word qawwam means one degree of additional responsibility. Because if you read the verse ahead, the verse says that Allah has given men more strength than the women. So because of that advantage, it's the duty of the men that they should take care of the women, they should not boss over them. Furthermore, Quran says in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 19, that treat your wife with equity and kindness even if you dislike her. Even if you don't like your wife, yet treat her with love and compassion. And treat her kindly, even if you dislike her. Even if you dislike her, treat her with kindness and compassion. And in Islam, we do not consider calling the woman as housewives. Housewife. You know, housewife, if you analyze, means she's married to the house. In Islam, we don't consider our women, they're married to the house, to be called housewives. You know, in English we have, what is her profession? Housewife. We in Islam prefer calling the women as homemakers, because they make the home, they build the home. So inshallah, I believe that the ladies from now onwards, when they have to fill any form, instead of writing the profession, if they are not right housewife, that's the English terminology. They are marrying you to your house. Prefer mentioning homemaker. Because the woman builds the home, they make the home. And in Islam, a woman is not married to a master to be treated like a slave. She is married to an equal, and the role is that of partnership. And Quran gives a very good phrase in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse 197, the Almighty God says, "Hunna libasul lakum wa antum libasul lahunna," that they are your garments and you are their garments. That means your wives are your garments and you are the garments of your wives. What is the role of garment? The role of the garment is to beautify, to conceal, to protect. The husband and wife, they conceal each other's faults. They beautify each other. They help each other. It is the role of hand and glove.
Such an amazing video right here, man. Such an amazing video right here. I mean, Dr. Zaki Naik has just explained it in a very good way. I mean, you can just what do you call this? You can just, it's a self-explanatory type of thing, you know. You can just have it and internalize it in a good way. But anyway, I just want to add up something. He talked about women. I believe that women are makers, you know, like they make things happen. You get it? Just like the way Dr. Zaki Naik said, women are homemakers. I mean, that's the perfect way of describing a woman, not calling them or not giving them a name like housewives. I don't feel housewife is a good name, but I feel like it shouldn't be. I think that's an English maybe term or whatever. I don't know. I feel it's not just correct to call a woman she's a housewife, you know. Women are homemakers, you know. Their intuition is really amazing. They make sure that things are in place and whatnot. And also, women are makers. I mean, by makers, I mean that they can nurture something to become greater. I mean, if they have that ability to make something, it means that they can also nurture somebody to become a better person. That's why they, you know, when they give birth, they raise children to become adults, or maybe to become a greater people in probably in life. You know, I mean, they play a very big role in life. You understand? I mean, women are just amazing. Shout out to all the women out there. So, Dr. Zakir actually really explained it in a very good way, and I believe that the rights of wives in Islam. I kind of got one or two things which is really informative and also educative, and I believe each and every religion has a way of treating a woman as a wife. And the way Dr. Zakir Naik just started his video by saying that in Islam they consider wives as that women are called probably the devil or something like that, but in Islam it's the opposite. They don't call them the devils, they call them I can't remember the word, but he explained that it's the opposite of what the other religions are calling women. I like the part where he said that if you don't like your woman or your wife, just treat her good, make her happy, treat her in a very respectable manner and stuff like that. But again, other people will start thinking that if you don't like your wife, why would you, you know, give all those good virtues to her? You get it? I mean, people are different. But anyway, what Dr. Zakir Naik just said was, I think, incredible. Anyway, thank you so much. I mean, such an amazing message. Thank you so much for being with me towards this end of this session. I mean, just let me know in the comment section below, what do you think on this video, rights of a woman in Islam? Do you think that women are respected that much, or do you think that women are not respected that much? I think when at this day and age, I think there's so much conditioning that is happening out there. I mean, there's this equal rights and what, which is, it's okay, you understand? But do you feel like back in those days they were more respected, women were more respected, other than this day and age that we live in today? Just let me know in the comment section below. And how would you treat, and would you treat your wife or would you treat your lady the same way Dr. Zakir Naik just explained on the video? Anyway, if you feel like you reacted to this video in a better way, just give me a thumbs up. And don't forget to go down in the comment section and tell me exactly what you feel about my reaction. What you feel about this video right here of rights of a wife in Islam by Dr. Zakir Naik. Just let me know in the comment section below. I posed in some questions. Just go in the comment section below. Just let me know of what you think. That's going to be really, really amazing. I mean, just give me your thoughts. Give me your thoughts. And also, the most important thing is don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Then we keep on subscribing. Then we'll give us the motivation to do a lot of videos and to give you better, better content. And last but not the least, I'm going to see you in the next video. And peace out.